most of Jews understand that they're strangers in this country. This country is not for Jews.
An ever more familiar sight. Thousands of Soviet Jews arriving in Israel. With so many coming out, the problems for Soviet Jews must surely be over.
I'm still a refusenik, and I have some other friends who are here and who are not only in Leningrad, who are still refuseniks.
Of course, the number of persons who are permitted to emigrate is much more than before. But still, the bank of refuseniks exists.
According to our statistics, we have now in Leningrad about 200 refuseniks. So in Moscow, maybe twice more. There are a lot of refuseniks.
We know personally about 400 families, but we know not all of them.
I had my first refusal in 1978.
The first time I applied in 1979.
I began applying for exit visa in 1979.
There are now not only so-called old refuseniks, but even now they create new refuseniks.
We have a special list of refuseniks, and we keep on filling it with the new names to keep it update, and we are sending it to the West.
But do the Soviet authorities give any reasons for not allowing these Jews out?
The authorities explained me that I know a lot of state secrets, so I can't live on the ground of state secrecy. But I left my secret job about 12 years ago, so in my opinion, it's only game.
I had secrets, but can you imagine, you see, for this period of time, that now is 1990, and I quit my job is 1977.
Some Soviet Jews can't even apply to leave, because relations refuse to state that they have no financial claims on the would-be emigrants. Many of these poor relatives are not recorded as refuseniks and remain largely unknown.
The situation becomes horrible when adult people who are sometimes grandparents are dependent on their relatives' wish, their parents' wish, whether they allow them to emigrate from this country.
Last year, the Soviet government promised a new emigration law, which would limit the term of secrecy to 5 years. But the law is expected to contain a clause which would mean this limit would not apply in so-called sensitive cases.
So in every particular case, they will say, yes, as a rule, 5 years, but your case is extremely dangerous. You will have to wait more than 5 years.
We think it's a very bad law. Not only for us first, and the second, for a lot of people who are going to leave.
Despite the fact that so many Jews can't leave, thousands of others are leaving with a newfound urgency. Why?
The main problem is how to get to Israel very quickly and what to do with anti-Semitism here. Because people, especially women, are very nervous with this problem.
Even as Soviet society becomes freer and democracy seems to be just around the corner, the country is in a disastrous economic state. The familiar queues outside the shops have grown even longer, and food like vegetables and fruit is often unavailable, even if people have the money to spend. The population's frustration and anger at the slowness of Gorbachev's success is strengthening resurgent Russian nationalism. The nationalists are hunting for scapegoats, and the scapegoats are the Jews.
I fear very much.
What do you fear?
I fear for my son, for my husband. Yes.
I've heard a lot of anti-Semitic sayings against me. But I've never been so frightened than it is now. I'm worrying about my daughter when she's outside at school or somewhere else. This is my feeling.
This is where the seeds of fear are planted, the headquarters of Pamyat, meaning memory. Pamyat is ultra-right-wing, highly nationalist, and overtly anti-Semitic. Dr. Valentina Uzanova, a non-Jewish researcher at Leningrad's Institute of Ethnography, has made a study of anti-Semitism in Leningrad.
At first, they expressed themselves openly enough. I'm talking about the period of spring and summer 1988, and they didn't think they needed to disguise their attitudes. At that time, at their meetings, they pointed openly at the Jews as the enemies of Russia. More recently, after an official warning from the city procurator's office and a series of adverse articles in the press, they began to behave more cautiously.
They openly protest against Jews. They say that Jews are the main reason of all mischiefs of Soviet Union, and that they must be driven away or maybe annihilated. So it is a very real possibility.
The problems of anti-Semitism are very close to many Russian people. There were meetings of Pamyat Society here many times, hundreds of people had opportunity to listen to their crazy ideas.
Even after their warning from the authorities, Pamyat still holds regular outdoor meetings. The police don't interfere with them. So what sort of people do Pamyat attract?
Judging from those leaders who have declared their professions, amongst them there are unfortunately many teachers, doctors, engineers, and even people from the creative professions.
This anti-Semitic tendency in the Russian intelligentsia is shown by a number of incidents in the writers' unions. At this meeting in Leningrad, one Jewish writer was posed this written question from the audience.
Теперь без зазрения совести топчете и унижаете их достоинство. По какому праву прошу ответить? По скрипту. Уверена, что по паспорту, как и 200 человек других в Союзе писателей, числитесь русским. И вам 61...
In this case, audience reaction was mixed, with some members showing embarrassment. But there have been much worse incidents, such as one in the Moscow Writers' Union.
At the very beginning of this meeting, a lot of people began to cry through megaphone anti-Semitic slogans. And there was a quarrel and there was even battles. And when writers asked militia for help, after half of hour of this raid, right? Only two militioners came, and they did nothing. And when writers tried to throw away these hooligans, the militia make them free immediately.
And why does this writer single out Jews for criticism?
You don't understand. It's because they have seized everything. They run literary magazines, publishing houses. That's why, even the Soviet mass media and newspapers.
Much of Pamyat's propaganda is carried on literature. In her office in Leningrad, Dr. Uzanova has collected hundreds of examples.
There is now so much anti-Semitic literature, which is somehow printed, copied and circulated as booklets, leaflets and so on. All of this has become easily accessible. They are actively studying and distributing materials of an anti-Semitic nature. And of course, they are using such serious literature as the Protocols of the Elders of Zion, which is widely circulated and can be purchased and read.
So why does so much Pamyat propaganda refer to Zionists rather than Jews?
It just seems to them that when they attack Zionism, they're acting as real patriots, supporting our country's policies.
The leader of Leningrad Pamyat, who say that all Jews are Zionists, all those who marry Jewish are Zionists, and all those who bribed by Jews are Zionists too.
They want to appear anti-Zionists, but when you look more closely at it, you'll see that they hate all the Jews, not only Zionists.
The majority of Russians do not know what Zionism is in reality. It is, they think maybe it is something connecting Jews with some plot against mankind.
The spread of anti-Semitism all over the Soviet Union is being observed by the leaders of this Moscow-based Zionist youth movement. The latest edition of their club magazine contains a disturbing letter from a 16-year-old girl from the Ukrainian town of Kharkov.
Once, when she was catching a taxi, the taximan took her to a very lonely place, though she didn't ask him. And there, several boys were waiting for her. They took a knife and cut out Magen David on her shoulder, and also they cut her through the blouse. And she was bleeding, and it was so terrible.
Many of my Jewish friends were beaten, and you see, even non-Jewish friends this summer on in June, they told me there was a rumor that on this day will be pogrom, and my Russian friends told me not to go outdoors because something can happen with me.
We will be the first victims of the people. They promise to arrange pogroms. Pogrom. It's a beating of Jewish people.
If you want to be a member of Pamyat, you have to fill an application and write 5 Jewish family addresses. If they will begin their pogroms, they will take all addresses and they will go to the flats.
And?
I don't want to speak about this. Too sad.
It's very difficult to tell the truth from the lies. And rumors are spreading in the city like snowballs. There are certain dates for pogroms and so on and so on. So that's why the people are panic.
I know that the United States and Europe have limited the number of entrance visas they issue. And so the Jews need to become political refugees. The Zionists are spreading these rumors of a pogrom to make more people want to emigrate.
The situation of fear is producing many rumors, often not based on reality. But this doesn't mean that we must wait until a pogrom actually happens before inciting a pogrom is made illegal.
It's necessary to protect the Jews, to protect synagogue, to protect all the people in this country before such terrible events.
The fear is such that many Jewish parents have withdrawn their children from their regular schools to study instead at the Jewish school in the Moscow Central Synagogue. Among them, this 13-year-old boy who was severely beaten by his gym teacher for no apparent reason.
После нескольких ударов под затылок у меня очень зашумело в ушах. Он мне нанес пинком, скинул меня с лестницы. Я остановился где-нибудь на половине лестницы.
И,
нет, не упал, я удержался. И он мне нанес удар под дых, то есть в живот.
Such irrational attacks are rare in Russia. And as he was the only Jewish boy in the class, his mother is sure it was an anti-Semitic attack. In this atmosphere, the Jews need to feel that the local police or militia will protect them. But there's little cause for optimism. Rules on public gatherings have been relaxed, and some large demonstrations, known about and covered by the media, have been tolerated. But smaller meetings, organized recently by long-term refuseniks, have been harshly broken up by the authorities.
After 4 minutes, about 80 policemen surrounding us, and we were arrested right away.
Took our people. Yes, and put them special bus.
Special bus.
And put them in prison.
We informed them beforehand, and instead of helping us, instead of trying to speak with us, to do something, they informed the police to stop the demonstration. That was their response for our appeal to them.
So can they rely on the authorities to protect them?
I hope that the democratic organizations in our city are strong enough to prevent it, and that the police and security forces will act according to their duties.
As far as I know, the PAMET and other anti-Semitic organizations have a lot of their supporters in the Ministry of Internal Affairs, and in military, among military men, and so on, and I'm not sure.
In Baku, for 3 days, there was a very barbaric Armenian pogrom, and the troops were sent there only after 3 days. So maybe they will defend us, but not at the first minute.
What about Mr. Gorbachev's reactions to anti-Semitism?
I don't remember any occasion that Gorbachev has said anything on the issue of anti-Semitism at all. No.
President Gorbachev certainly, in my opinion, doesn't want to have anti-Semitism in this country. But unfortunately, not a single word about it wasn't said by him.
How do you think he will come to Leningrad, to Soyuza Pechatinka Street, to flat number 84, and he will stand near my flat and said, I don't want you to beat Kate?
The Soviet Union has proposed that a human rights conference should be held in Moscow in 1991. How do the refuseniks react to this?
It's impossible to have a conference on human rights in the country where there are absolutely no human rights laws.
Even now we have some political prisoners. Some of them are very well known in the West, Lubman, Kazachkov, and some others.
They haven't fulfilled the promises to get rid of all the refuseniks. They haven't fulfilled the promises about the law on immigration, which should correspond to the international law. I think that Britain should demand that the promises of the Soviet government should be fulfilled before they go to the conference.
It's like to organize festival of dance in a society where the people had no legs.
In spite of doubts and fears, the Russian Jewish Renaissance continues, and children learn about their heritage from a very young age.
Во! От гора!
Они гора бы
Гора! Они гора!
Они гора бы мозга!
Until I started my Jewish activities, I was not really very happy. I didn't have many Jewish friends, and I didn't see anything good in being Jewish. It just as a stigma. But now I think that being Jewish is a fun.
No one knows what the future holds for Jews in the Soviet Union. But for many thousands who have not yet managed to emigrate, and for those who may have no intention of leaving, life has become clouded with fear.
A traditional saying in our country goes, let's kill the Jews and save Mother Russia.
I'm proud about our history, about our famous people, and I consider it's a good It's a big honor to be a Jew.
This country is not the place to be a happy Jew.
I don't want to develop my culture in this country. I want to develop it in Israel.
I want to be among my brothers. I want to be a Jew.
Everybody now wants to go to Israel. It is the beginning of Exodus.